doing this. They used to throw in kayaks in the back of this sucker. Roy and I are gonna do the same thing that Alan and I did last weekend. Do the mountain bike self-shuttle. It was good to us last weekend. Hopefully, it's good to us today. Before we head out today, I wanted to show you a little bit about our shop and how we make some of the things we do. Confidence Baits really is a, you know, local homegrown business, and I got someone I work with at my regular job that comes here and does all of our lead pouring for us. We got some neat production molds that help us crank this up, suckers out pretty quickly. Here's our powder painting operation here, just the heat gun and the fluid bed, a couple toaster ovens, and yeah, everything we need is right here to crank out these dragon heads, the regular little jig heads for the little tubes, everything we need right here.
Looking at the Susquehanna River gauge for Harrisburg, checking out what the water level is predicted to do. If you look at the screen here, you can see that it had gone down up through Thursday, but now with the rain that we've got in the past 3 days, it's coming back up. It's going to level off for a little while and then come back up again. So we'll be fishing sort of stable water this morning, but it's still been on the rise for the past day. So that should make the fishing a little bit different than it was last week when Jeff fished the same float. We'll be fishing water that's slightly on the rise. Says we're gonna have a cloudy day with a high near 75 and light north wind with a 30% chance of precipitation. Juniata looks like it's pretty stable. It's just starting an upswing, so we might be seeing a little of the water that they got further north finally starting to make its way down to us down here.
It's funny that, you know, you can almost tell from last night's rain by looking at the gauge how big of a tributary you're looking at. The smaller ones will spike real quick and jump back down, and we're just now starting to see, you know, yesterday's rain show up on one of the larger tributaries. All right, we're pulled over on the side of Route 15. We were coming up the river and looked out at it, and we can see one of the tributaries that we had looked at the gauges really from last night's rain. It's spewing mud, so we were gonna put in a little bit below that and float down, but I want to get above it. I'd prefer not to be in all that mud. You know, bass are sight feeders, and certainly when they need to, they can overcome that using their lateral line and hearing and all their other senses. But if I can drive to clearer water, I'm gonna do that, and that's what we're doing today. We're changing our game plan up a little bit. I have two resources to help me with that. One is this little map here that I got from Blue Mountain Outfitters, a local paddle shop in Marysville, Pennsylvania. They made this real nice little map, and it shows, they got a mileage grid here that helps you figure out, okay, from, and we're gonna do Liverpool to Clemson Island today. And if you look at the grid here, it'll show that that's an 8 mile float, which is reasonable. It's a reasonable float, and it's a, you know, reasonable bike ride for me to self-shuttle. This is the tributary that's right now spewing a lot of mud, so we're gonna get upstream from that, and there's Liverpool, and there is Clemson right there. And that's gonna be a good float because it gets us through. Here's one mountain range here, and here's another there. So that puts us through two really big sets of ledges, and we should have some real good ledge trench type structure to fish today. So, and we're gonna have clear water. never seen more roadkill frogs as I just did. I bet you I saw, I don't know, 150, 200 of those suckers. It's definitely, that sort of migration is certainly a sign that summer's wrapped up and they're moving to places to hibernate or winter. I'm using these real big tubes today on the 3/8 ounce dragon head. I got a little glass rattle that I just crazy glued it right in the end there. Makes a real nice sound. I've always loved these glass rattles. But when we were putting in over there, I watched a crayfish scoot away, and I pre-rigged this one. It's a nice crayfish color, that brown with red fleck, but that's not the color of the one I saw. So I'm switching over. I got one here. It's more of that green color that I saw. Nice green pumpkin. That one's got red fleck in it. Just twist that on the hitching post there. And I've used these for years. These are actually my original confidence baits. I used these big tubes almost exclusively for a good number of years. And the only problem I had with them pretty consistently was the hookup percentage, because it was such a thick-walled tube. And I'd cram a jig head in there and then a rattle and set the hook and it wouldn't collapse. So I'd miss a lot of fish. I'd get a lot of big fish to bite that, but I'd miss a lot of them too. I think I fixed that here with the 3/8 ounce dragon head, because it's all hollow. All that cavity that I used to fill with the jig head, the weight is down below. The rattle is on this side of it, and that's all nice and hollow. So we get a real nice, nice hook set there. I'll just finish it off with some Mega Strike there. Make it taste good.
We've got a Gold Shiner Clacker spinnerbait here. I'm going to be trying some today. I'm going to bulk it up a little bit and put one of our Lumachog birds on the back of it to add a little bulk and a little bit more action to the bait. I'm going to rig it with the tail horizontal to the bottom, so hopefully that'll give it a little bit more action.
Had one bite on the green, missed him. I just wasn't quick enough on the hook set. But we've actually rode into some water with a little bit more stain. So I'm switching from that green pumpkin with red flake to this black one with red flake. I think the darker colors show up a little bit better. And it's not chocolate milk by any means, but any advantage that helps them with their dominant sight, their dominant sense, which is sight. I'm gonna play to that as much as I can. All right, we're just drifting through here, not really casting at anything, and I got the same thing, same Mumachog bird on the 1/4 ounce head that I had up on the Juniata a couple weeks ago. I'm just lifting it and dropping it. Just straining water with this, which is not how I usually fish them. Just a real small minnow profile. Lift, drop, lift, drop. Hi there. They think nothing of it. This little Mumachog bird. I'm with the 1/4 ounce today. We got good current. See you, buddy. Please upload and watch Confidence Baits TV, Episode 2, Part 2. Confidence Baits, when nothing else works.